So welcome back all of you again to today's class on proper cantilevers. Yeah. Now you can see this. Analysis of proper cantilever beams. Okay. First, I will explain the basic fundamental concepts associated with strength of materials, and then we can go on and solve using any other technique. Of course, we also can use conjugate beam method. It's an easy technique similar to moment area method, but the only thing is you need to understand how to know the area and the centroidal distance of the bending moment diagram. So before starting this, let me first try to explain a simple problem that is determining the reaction components of a proper cantilever subjected to UDL. The first one, so a proper cantilever with a UDL of W kilonewton per meter and length is L, point is A, this point is B. Calculate the reaction components of the beam. So now, for finding the solution to this problem, using the method of consistent deformation, using the method of consistent deformation, proper cantilever can be analyzed. So for that to happen, so we need to follow certain steps. So what are the steps? So first we need to convert the given proper cantilever beam into a determinate structure by removing the redundant member. For the given beam, degree of static indeterminacy is equal to 4 minus 3, that is equal to 1. Degree of static indeterminacy is equal to 1. For the analysis, let us remove one of the reaction component as a redundant. So for that, let us sketch the free body diagram. So you have vertical reaction here, vertical reaction here, and a moment. Now when we talk about the two vertical reactions and a moment at the end, so what do we need to do? So two reactions are to be there. I have neglected the axial deformation because that is nowhere related right now. With a load of W kilonewton per meter. Okay. Now, with this problem, we need to choose any one reaction component as a redundant and try to remove that. Okay. So let us see how to do that. So now, for the sake of simplicity, so this is RA, RB, MA. Let us consider reaction RB as redundant and remove it to make the beam a statically determinate to make the beam statically determinate. So what does that mean? So this is like a cantilever beam with UDL, isn't it? W kilonewton per meter. That's what we need to do. Now, the deflected shape, of the cantilever, the deflected shape of the cantilever is given by what? We need to sketch the deflected shape of the cantilever. So how do we do that? So there is an UDL here. And the deflected shape will be this. In fact, it is zero here. So zero, and it will start. So this is delta R delta 1. Let us say it is delta 1 or any delta you can use upon your choice. So what is delta 1? Deflection of a cantilever with point load, isn't it? And we all know how to sketch the bending moment diagram. So how to sketch the bending moment diagram? So this is UDL, W kilonewton per meter, isn't it? Now, when we talk about the behavior of this beam, we need to sketch the bending moment diagram, because for conjugate beam or any other beam, we need the bending moment diagram. So that bending moment diagram is actually sketched as either positive or negative, whatever it might be, whatever we consider. I hope you all might remember this, how to sketch it. You have to remember, because you should not forget how to sketch the bending moment diagram. So this is how the bending moment diagram would look like. Okay. So this will be W L square by 2. Okay. This will be W L square by 2. Now, when we are sketching the bending moment diagram for a cantilever beam with UDL, we can also calculate what? We can calculate its deflection. We can easily try to calculate the deflection of a cantilever beam with the point with UDL. Actually, it is W L power 4 by ATI. If you know the answer, you can directly take it. W L power 4 by ATI. But the thing is, once we try to take that, or you can simply take another option of choosing the area of the bending moment diagram into its centroidal distance. Area of the bending moment diagram into its centroidal distance. So either way, it's possible, and we should know how to use the expression, how to draw the bending moment diagram, and how to write the area multiplied by centroidal distance. So that's what I'll show. So the deflection delta 1 is given by area of the bending moment diagram into centroidal distance. Area of the bending moment diagram into centroidal distance. So area means for parabola. So this is like a parabolic shape, kind of cubic parabola. So this is given by 1/3 of area means 1/3 of what is the length? L. So this is L. This is L into W by EI. In fact, W L square by 2EI into. So this is the area into centroidal distance from B. From B, this is the point, will be 3/4 of L. Okay, so 3 will get cancelled, and you will get it like W L power 4 by 8EI. So this is the deflection of cantilever beam with UDL. Now this is our delta 1. So this is equal to delta 1. Now, next step, consider the beam with upward reaction RB at the free end. So how do we get that? Now it is like a cantilever beam with point loaded free end, isn't it? So once we sketch it, so see how it looks like. This is just like an upward reaction. Consider the beam with upward reaction RB at the free end on the cantilever. So this is RB. So this is cantilever beam with point loaded free end, but upward load. So this is your another deflection. What is this deflection? Delta 2 or delta 2. Now we need to sketch the bending moment diagram for this also. So this is RB, isn't it? This is L, isn't it? This is A. Now to sketch the bending moment diagram, what do we need to do? We need to consider the point load concept. So if you can see that, so this is the bending moment diagram, that is RB into L, isn't it? RB into L, simple, direct concept, RB into L. So this is the bending moment diagram. Now deflection delta 2 is equal to area of bending moment diagram multiplied by center of gravity. So what is the area of the bending moment diagram? Half into base into height into centroidal distance is 2/3 from B. So half into base into height by EI into 2/3 of L. So 2 will get cancelled, and you will get it as RB into L cube by 3EI, that is equal to delta 2. Now you all understood, right? For UDL as well as this part. Now for any given problem, if you want to calculate this deflection. This is common for all the problems. Just take the upward load, calculate the deflection as RBL cube by 3A. This is always an unknown. As long as you are removing the RB as a redundant, this will be your unknown. So now what do we need to do? Using the concept of method of consistent deformation. Okay. For using the method of consistent deformation, using the method of consistent deformation, delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to 0. Delta 1 plus delta 2 is equal to 0. That means WL power 4 by 8 EI plus RBL cube by 3 EI is equal to 0. RBL cube by 3 EI EI will get cancelled is equal to minus WL power 4 by 8. So RB is equal to how much? RB is equal to how much? We need to calculate that. So how much? So when we equate both, RB is equal to 3 by 8 minus, or even you can say that 3 by 8 into WL. 3 by 8 into WL, because it's an upward reaction. We have taken it as an upward reaction. It got negative. So we can directly take it as RB is equal to 3 by 8 WL. Now, once we get the RB value, how to get the moment? So RA plus RB is equal to W into L into L by 2. Isn't it? In fact, this is W into L. Cantilever, right? So RA is equal to WL minus 3 by 8 WL. So RA is equal to, ultimately strength of material concept we are learning as it is, 5 by 8 into WL. Now we need the moment. MA is equal to, how do we need to do? RB into L minus W into L into L by 2. Simple concept. So 3WL square by 8 minus WL square by 2. Isn't it? Now, once we take this LCM, 8 is the LCM. So 3 minus 4. So minus WL square by 8. So this is how we calculate the reaction components of a propped cantilever beam. Reactions of a propped cantilever beam with UDL. The very important problems in variety of the examinations that you come across. Okay, so simple concept. And next we will see how to do it for a proper cantilever beam with triangular load and with different point loads, and concept is same. Okay.